I got mail. This is an extension to my 3018 CNC. A 3018 CNC is fun, but it's too small. Let's mount this thing. So, these are all the parts. Looks all right, I guess. I have no idea. Got nothing to complain about this far. It was well packaged, and as far as I can tell, it's fairly straight. Nothing is bent, packaging wasn't damaged. That looks all right. Now, I have built an enclosure for my CNC. Obviously, it's going to be way too small after I mounted this. That's a project for another day, I think. Now, I'm going to dismount this, disassemble it, assemble this. There were no instructions, but that's all right. I think this is going to be pretty self-explanatory. Hopefully. All right, montage time. This extension kit is known as a 3040 extension kit. That's a bit of an oversell, but we'll get somewhat close to it in the end. In order to mount it, I have to extract my CNC from the enclosure and disassemble it. The X-axis gantry has to be separated from the base, the cutting table removed, and a Y-axis lead screw removed and replaced. The same goes for the Y-axis linear rails. The connector between the stepper motor and the lead screw is replaced as well, as the new couplers are flexible as opposed to old rigid ones. I reassembled and mounted the table again, roughly positioning the X-axis gantry. The positioning of the table isn't done yet though, it will be properly squared later on. However, I did give it my best at this point, but luckily I had better luck after it was all assembled and connected. I also removed the X-axis lead screw, as I was to replace it with one a bit longer to accommodate an adjustment knob at the end of it, like the one on the Y-axis lead screw. The coupler is replaced as well, of course. I then position the table of the CNC and the X-axis gantry. I make sure the end of the router motor will be as centered on the table as possible. Then I detach the controller board from my enclosure, mounted it temporarily to the X-axis gantry and connected the wires in order to be operational again. The controller board will later be moved to outside the new enclosure to keep it safe from sawdust from my CNC routing projects. In the end, I do some final adjustments to make sure the table is as squared as possible, but I did forget to lubricate the new lead screws and linear rails. I've done so after shooting this video, and it removed most of the whining and rattling sounds you are about to hear. All right. It's up and running. It makes a whining sound sometimes, going backwards on the y-axis by a huge distance, and it makes a rattling sound going forward on the same axis. The rattling sound is down to the backlash screw not being tight in there, so it's actually rattling around moving forward. Doesn't do that going backwards, so we'll see if it bothers me enough to actually make me do something about it. Anyway, this 3018 cheapo CNC from China has now gone from a capacity of approximately 30 by 18 to 30 by 34. More or less. Next thing I'll have to do is make a wasteboard and an enclosure. But as I've been having a beer while doing this, I will not operate my table saw. That will be another project for another day. For now, I'm happy I've got this thing up and running and it seems to be working just fine. It's still not rigid on the x-axis. Y-axis is surprisingly solid. But we'll see how this turns out in the end. If you've been watching this far, I really appreciate it. Please remember to give me a thumbs up if you like the video, subscribe and all that. Nah, never mind. Subscribe if you want to. I'm gonna keep making videos anyway. Yeah, there's another video up there or up there, I'm not really sure, that YouTube thinks you will like. And yeah, that's all. See you later.